Tonight, we have an opportunity to celebrate achievements in education right here in our backyard. And first, what I'd like to ask each of you to do is just reflect for a moment on the importance that education played in your own family story. Just reflect for a moment, how did education opportunities benefit your family? For me, my grandfather came, on my mom's side, my Zadie, came when he was 14 years old, barely speaking English. He worked very hard in his brother's store until he could save up and open up his own deli in Philadelphia. My other grandfather, my pop-up, William, he worked two jobs to support his family, and two factory jobs to support his family, and they both knew, however, that education was going to be the gateway to opportunity and could have a transformative impact on our family. And at the time, city schools were good enough and higher education was inexpensive enough that they could do that, and education could have that impact. So while my grandfathers never went to college, my father became a law professor, educating the next generation. My mother became a high school teacher and a social worker. And so I think my own passion for the transformative power of education is really rooted in my grandfather's dreams for their families. And when I went to LPS, Leadership Public Schools, we call LPS, when I went to Leadership Public Schools Hayward this week, that my grandfather's voices and your grandfather's voices were echoed in the hallways of Leadership Public Schools. And I kind of heard it in the youth that I met, like Nevin, who we'll hear from in a moment. And at a time, by the way, Nevin didn't know this, that I'm not sure if all of you do, that California has more kids in our public schools than 36 other states do in total, which is kind of an extraordinary stat if you think about it. But at a time when that's the case, as we all know, too few students in California have a real college opportunity. We know about barriers from inadequate schools, from dangerous communities, from rising costs. And LPS, one of the reasons I love LPS, and I'm proud to talk about LPS tonight, is LPS is proof that all kids in California, given the right opportunity, can build a better life. They can build a better life for themselves and for their families. And so the results are astounding when you think about it. So LPS, which operates four public charter schools, and they're all in very high poverty parts of the Bay Area, but this is astounding stat, 97% of their students are accepted to four-year college. 97% of students are accepted to four-year college. And even more extraordinarily, LPS Hayward, where I was this week, the scores of the students in LPS Hayward are on par with any students in the most affluent parts of the state. And how do they do this? When I was in LPS, one of the first things I saw that was really struck by was I saw banners. I saw a black and gold banner for Colorado. I saw a blue and gold banner for Berkeley. I saw a cardinal and white banner for Stanford. And these were the banners of where the teachers had gone. And where the kids could aspire to go. And I heard about all the things that LPS does to have kids believe, help them believe that they too can go to college. And when I walked into classrooms, I walked into Teacher Rose's classroom, I saw what an effective use of technology means and what it can mean in the classroom. I saw students like Jorge and Anna and the rest of their class all inputting answers into a smartphone. They do this at the beginning of the class and his middle, end of the class, into a smartphone, and instantly projected on the wall, and the teacher has a heat map on her iPad. She can see how the whole class is doing and who needs help in that moment. It's a program called Exit Ticket. It's one of the things that Full Circle Fund has helped fund recently with LPS, and the results are extraordinary, as you'll hear about in a moment. Not only extraordinary, they're necessary, because if you're not at grade level by the end of 10th grade, you cannot go to CSU. You cannot go to UC. And this means passing algebra, Algebra 1, chemistry, lots of classes that these kids come into high school not prepared to tackle. So we'll hear about that more in a moment and the extraordinary results at LPS. And it's really extraordinary stuff. It makes me very proud that Full Circle Fund had the honor, I'd say, of incubating LPS out of our offices over 10 years ago. So thank you. So Jeff Camp and Eva Camp worked on the very first project with what at the time was Leadership High School. And that's what, you know, being around for more than a decade means to us. It means we get to see the results. It's the thousands of kids that are now going to college who might not have had that opportunity if not for LPS, if not for Full Circle Fund, if not for great board members like Sheryl Sandberg for LPS, and not for all of you who have supported our work in this time and doing this. So I want to thank all of you for supporting that work. And this is just an example of what Full Circle Fund does. We take good ideas, great leaders, and we help accelerate their impact. We communicate, we give our time, we give our money and our connections. Just last night, thanks to Cooley Godward, one of our sponsors, and Peter Werner, helped connect Louise up with a licensing attorney for something that was critical for her. So we all give our networks, we all give whatever we can to support these organizations. And, you know, it's great, it's a promising start, but it's not enough. We all can do more. And what I just want us to think about for a moment is, just think about, well, if we all put our time, everyone in this room and all your friends and people you know, we put our time and money together and we think about what are the, you know, what transformative impact we can have by supporting groups like LPS, supporting folks who are having an impact in our community. That's what we're trying to do. So to reflect back on education for a moment, perhaps an English writer, C.K. Chesterton, said it best. He said, education is merely the soul of a society as it passes from one generation to another. So it's my great honor to welcome a pioneer in education to the stage next. Louise Waters was the associate superintendent at the Oakland Schools. She worked at the Stubsky Foundation, first funding research into what were the greatest solutions out there that were actually advancing advancing results for students of color and for students of poverty. And then, even before that, she was a professor and started one of the very first teacher education programs, the most successful teacher education programs in the state. So it's my great honor and privilege to welcome the superintendent and CEO of Leadership Public Schools, Louise Waters. Thank you very much.
Thank you so much, Josh. And for us at LPS, This evening is a celebration of an amazing partnership that's come in three phases. As Josh said, it began 10 years ago when Full Circle Fund joined Sheryl and Leadership Public Schools in making a commitment to transforming the lives of urban youth in the Bay Area by providing educational opportunities. And in a few minutes, you'll hear from Nevin Lal, one of our seniors, that we've come a long way in making those early goals a reality. A year and a half ago, Full Circle Fund again came forward as we moved to scale our commitment by leveraging technology to make teaching and learning smarter. At some of our schools, the average ninth grader comes in with skills at the fourth or fifth grade level. That's the average ninth grader. If a student is to be ready to succeed in college, they must be at grade level by 10th grade in order to be ready to enter college without remediation by the time of graduation. This is a huge acceleration that they need to go from fourth grade level to 10th grade level in 2 years. And to address this need, we partnered with Full Circle Fund and we have developed a data app called Exit Ticket, which is what Josh saw when he came to Hayward 2 days ago, I think it was. And what we've done is made LPS into an R&D center focusing on how to address these challenges. And like Josh said, this is a very simple tool, but it allows students to have just in time, to take mini quizzes just in time. It allows teachers to see the results on heat maps. And for the teacher to be able to, at any moment, go to an individual student, see what they're missing, give them intervention, not wait till tutoring after school, address their needs right there, pull a small group together, and only teach things to the whole class when most of the students need that instruction. While this provides incredible personalization and efficiency for teachers, it's even more important for students. Students who enter high school with skills at the fourth or fifth grade level are not fifth graders. Those students who are taking algebra in ninth grade have probably seen many of those concepts four or five times. And by now, they don't believe that they can master them. And this is, I was thinking about this when you were talking, Chelsea, that in urban high schools, there's a very inexpensive, extremely powerful resource, and that's the students. And once the students believe in themselves, they can make incredible leaps. And that's what we've found. We've found that this opportunity for them to see micro successes, moment to moment micro successes, has allowed them to really engage and believe in themselves. The classes catch on fire. Students go home, they're challenging each other on Facebook. We have average growth of 2.5 years per year from this work. So because of these results, we were approached to sell Exit Ticket. And we have spent a considerable amount of time thinking about this and decided not to. In our due diligence, we came to realize that LPS is one of the only instances in this country where educational technology is being built in the classrooms, in schools. So we decided that actually keeping the IP and continuing this kind of R&D was our mission. And it is the way that we intend to have scale and impact. So we turned again to Full Circle Fund. And what they are doing now is partnering with us to help us deal with issues of IP and licensure. So I want to thank all of you who are for Full Circle Fund for the support you've given us over these three phases. It's been amazing, and we really appreciate it. Thanks to you, we're finding incredible results with our students. And as Josh said, our students in Hayward are performing at the level of students in San Ramon, in Pleasant Hill, in all across the Bay Area. So I'd want you to meet now one of them to introduce you a little bit to what happens to an LPS student and why we're all here. So I'd like you to meet Nevin Lawless, senior at LPS Hayward.
Thank you, Dr. Waters. You know, growing up without a mother and a father, it wasn't the easiest thing for me. My sister gave all of her life in order to raise me. She gave up her college dreams to raise me. So she told me that I had to be the one that had to make it. And I had to be the first one in my family to go to college. But the thing about that was, when I got older, I began to question that goal. You see, I didn't know why I was going to college, and I didn't know how I was going to get there, so I just gave up on it. And once I gave up on school, my failing grades definitely reflected that. Now, I was only in middle school then, and my sister feared that if I went to a regular high school in Hayward, not only would my apathy continue and my failing grades would continue, but they would probably worsen. So she enrolled me in the lottery to go to LPS Hayward, and whether it was by luck or by blessing, I definitely got in. Now, when I got in, it was before my freshman school year even began that I began to see the high esteem with which college is held at LPS. At a three-day retreat at Stanford University, I was introduced to LPS Hayward. And their goal, their basic mission statement to get 100% of their students into a college. Yeah, right. So my apathy and my bad behavior, it continued. And as much as I tried to fight everything, it got so bad that I had to leave LPS for an entire year, take a whole break off of school for an entire year. But after that year, when all hope just seemed lost for me, I got a call from LPS. They were asking me to come back. When I came back, upon my return, I became molded into the individual that you see before you today, the boy that became a man, not only willing to live out his dreams, but his family's dreams. Because I attend a school that works hard every single day to make sure that my sister's goal is met. I will be applying to 11 colleges this year, 7 of which I've seen from the numerous college tours that LPS has provided me. Wherever I choose to go to college, I plan to major in psychology. Better yet, I plan to get my PhD in psychology so I can help youths that were troubled, just like I used to be troubled, so that maybe, just maybe, I can instill within them what LPS has instilled within me. Because I went from failing 2 classes in the 7th grade to taking 3 AP courses currently in the 12th grade. No, seriously, I just took my Unit 3 physics exam today. From failing those classes in the 7th grade to now in the 12th grade, where my lowest grade is a B. LPS has not only helped me earn the grades to get into college, but more importantly, it has taught me to believe that college is not only a reality for me, but it's more than a dream for my sister. Thank you.